In New Zealand's flatlands, we farm cows. In our hilly parts, we farm sheep. But in the Mackenzie country, they farm fish.
Yes, the salmon industry there has just turned 30. And to mark the anniversary, they've hatched, pun intended, a bold new plan. Julian Lee reports.
One of the last places on Earth, and it looks like it. Barren and cold, infertile, inhospitable.
In the shadow of Mount Cook, the Mackenzie country has always been a tough place to make a living. But the folks here have always figured it out. Now it's the home of hydro, the best night sky in the world, and quietly, salmon farming. 30 years old this year.
A couple of keen fishermen, and they were fishing in the canals, and then they said to each other, "Oh, this would be a great place to raise salmon." But the unfortunate thing was that nobody had ever done it anywhere in the world.
In a short space of time, it's become a multi-million dollar industry. As legend has it, the Japanese emperor himself has dined on Mount Cook salmon.
The water quality is extremely high. It's got very high levels of oxygen when it comes through the power stations. It gets churned up.
Oh, I think I just saw one. Or was that a duck?
No, that would have been a very large trout.
As different as it may seem to traditional New Zealand farming, the basics are all there. These ponds can be subdivided into what they call paddocks.
What is this, by the way? Can you eat it?
Yes.
You can?
Yeah.
What is it? I quite like it.
It's a range of things. It's protein. It's got fish oil.
We don't have enough.
No, but the boys have already fed them. We're just giving them afternoon tea.
This is just for TV. Yeah.
The idea of feeding is to actually give the biggest spread to offer it to the most fish to stop them.
So like this?
Go.
Oh, I dropped some.
Yeah.
Is it like that?
Yeah, do another one. That's good.
Is that too dramatic?
It's not dramatic.
No. How'd you get into it?
It dawned on me that I knew about the hydroelectric system and how it worked, and they and nobody else knew about how to raise them in the canal. So I offered my services and have basically been here ever since.
What were the first days like? Was it quite awkward? Was there a lot of trial and error and that sort of stuff?
An enormous lot of trial and error. We lost a lot of fish. We did a lot of learning. Look at that.
How heavy is that?
This is about 5 kilos, isn't it?
The problem now, though, is the salmon farmers have maxed out the canals.
There's nowhere else to go, so the next question is, well, if we can't do it in the canals, the answer is, let's have a go at doing it outside the canals.
The new idea, announced just hours ago, is to build above-ground tanks deep inland, away from the canals, and pump water to and from them.
And how do you get the water that you're pumping it, or you're just getting
trucks? It's going to have to be a very large pump and pump it out.
But you've obviously done all the maths, and it's, you know.
Yep, the science of these things is there. I suggest you have a crack at that.
Yeah, I like these double-ended chopsticks. I don't think I've actually seen these before. These are very handy, yeah.
Well, what are you going to say? It's awesome. I mean, I could eat this stuff all day. Oh, so good.
This is the ultimate luxury food of modern times, eh?
You eat a lot of it, and you don't suddenly think, oh, man, I've overdone that.
No.
You can kind of just keep going.
You can just keep going,
We could clean this up.
Give a man a fish and feed him for a day. Plant a fish farm miles away from the sea at the bottom of the world. And feed everyone, apparently, including the Japanese emperor himself, for a lifetime.